All right, everybody, welcome to Go in 5 Minutes, episode 19. Let's talk about JSON today. So we got a request from TM Carr on GitHub. They're wondering, what should I do if I got JSON, let's say over the network or from a file or whatever, but I don't know what it looks like, okay? So if you knew what it looked like, that's easy, right? You can go and you can define a struct and you can unmarshal into the struct and you're good to go. But you might not always know what it looks like. You might get some random stuff from a random user, and you still got to deal with it, right? Sometimes it's not good enough to just say, nope, error. Sometimes you got to deal with it. Or maybe you've got a bunch of different kinds of JSON to expect, and you got to deal with all of them in a different way, right? So I'll say this now and later. There is a nice little bit.ly library called go-simple-json. I encourage you to check that out. Makes a nice kind of interface abstraction around the stuff I'm going to show. But the stuff I'm going to show is super simple. And it's really nice sometimes to be able to like take this and customize it for your own needs instead of getting the bigger library, the simple JSON library, and customizing that for what you need. Okay. So first things first, we're going to look at the kind of JSON we're going to decode. All right, so we got some basic JSON types down here. We got integer, we've got a string, right? It's fairly straightforward stuff. But then we've got a list, and that list has some crazy stuff inside of it. We've got an integers, we've got a string, we've got a dictionary in there, and then we've got our dictionary as well, right? So we've got an integer in there, we've got a string in there, we've got a list of various things in there, and we've even got a dictionary inside of the dictionary too, right? So how are we going to handle all of this stuff? All right, let's go into our main. Okay, so in our main, we've got kind of the same block of code over and over, right? We basically call unmarshal, and then we call iface to string, okay? So what does unmarshal do? Unmarshal takes in the JSON string. So this is the raw JSON. We've got no idea what it looks like. It loads that JSON string into memory, and that's it, right? So we get back that interface, and we have no idea what the JSON is. We just know that it's in memory, and we're good to go from there. Okay, next step, we pass that interface into iface to string, right? So that's short for interface to string. What iface to string does, it takes that kind of unknown JSON that we've got in memory. It goes and figures out what are the different components of it. What are the actual Go types that represent the JSON? And then it formats those super nicely as another string that kind of represents what this thing looks like in Go, okay? So this is kind of the simplest way to deal with the JSON, just to spit it back out. But of course, you could adapt this function. This is where you can make your own magic happen, okay? So let's go first to unmarshal. This is a simple one. It's probably kind of a familiar pattern. You're defining your interface here. This is just nil. You create that decoder. You pass in string to the decoder. And here's the magic. We call decode. We decode the entire JSON string into this interface, right? That's it. We just return it and we're done, okay? So again, we're taking that string, we're loading it into memory, which means we're making sure like it's valid JSON, and then we're just shoving it into interface saying, well, I'm on Marshall, I got no idea what this is, I just know that it's right. It's valid JSON, okay? Now we go down to where the party's at. Iface to string, right? So we know that iface at this point is valid JSON. Now we've got to do a type switch over it. So little recap here, in the type switch, T is going to be the actual type in our case statement, right? So first case statement, T is going to be that map, okay? And in the map, we basically just range over all the key value pairs. So key is going to be the string, value is going to be the interface, and then we recurse, right? So we call iface the string again. We call it on that value, which is the interface. And then iface the string goes down the stack until it gets to where it can actually output a real string in the base case, and I'll show that in a second. And then we make our nice little key colon value, a nice little formatted string here, and we make the whole dictionary with the squigglies around it and everything. Okay, kind of a similar story with the list. So we've got a slice of interfaces. We range over the slice. Each val in the slice is an interface. So we're just going to pass that in. We're going to do our recursion. Once we get back the actual string for that value, we're going to just put it into our strings and make it a nice little list with the brackets around it and everything. Okay. So again, I mean, we've got an interface in Val. This could be anything. This could be another JSON dictionary. It could be another list. Who knows? Right. So now here are our base cases. These don't recurse anymore because we know how to make these into a string directly. Integer, JSON number, string. We could add more of these as we go if we wanted to. All right, so real quick, let's see this run. We're gonna build it, we're gonna run it, and there you go. Okay, so we've got the dictionary, we printed out the dictionary properly so we know that we can read it, we can figure out what's going on with it. Same with the list, the integer, the string, right? So now that we can load it into memory and now we can act on it, you can add your own magic into here, right? You don't just have to spit it out as another string, okay? So that's just about it, just about wraps it up. Just once again, I encourage you to go check out this Go Simple JSON package. So it comes out of Bitly, and it's got this nice kind of abstraction over the basic fundamentals that I was talking about today. So I encourage you to check this out, see if it'll work for your purposes. I'd also encourage you to kind of steal this little bit of code that I wrote as well. See if this is all you need. See if you know you might be able to add stuff to here. But either way, this kind of can help you build that basic understanding of what's going on underneath the covers in the simple JSON package. All right, so that'll just about do it for today. Thanks everyone for watching, and I will hope to see you next time. Take it easy.